Welcome back. In part one of this video, we covered many of the basic concepts of ice and built a simple deformation. In the second part, we'll look at some of the tools for debugging ice trees and also show how to export and reuse a compound. You can display ice data in the 3D views to see what's going on. Right-click on the connection between the grid's point positions and the Add node to show its values. Depending on the data type, there are several options for displaying the data. Ice does not know, for example, whether a 3D vector represents a position or just a length and direction, or whether it should be interpreted in local or global coordinates. Since these are local point positions, choose points and leave the global option unchecked. It can be visually confusing when there is a lot of data to display, as in this case. One way to simplify the view is to display data for selected components only. Now you can see the original point positions of specific points in green. Display value 2, but this time choose vector trails and change the color. You can now see how the new position is the sum of the original position, the green dot, and the added vector, the purple line. Remember that the values you see depend on where they are displayed in the tree. For example, if you display the point positions after you set them to new values, you will see the new positions. When you are satisfied with your tree, you can package it as a compound to use it in other scenes. Select all the nodes except for Get Ball and the Root, then right-click on one of the selected nodes and choose Create Compound. If you open the compound's property editor, you can see that there aren't any controls exposed yet. Click the pop-up E to edit the compound. Expose the scalar multiplier as an input port and call it Amplitude. You can also expose the F-curve profile. Change the compound name to something more descriptive, such as bulge by distance. The category is used to organize compounds on the tool tab of the preset manager. If you don't specify a category, the compound will not appear on the tool tab. The task and subtask are used to organize compounds on the task tab. Separate the task from the subtask with a slash, and separate multiple tasks and subtasks with commas. Once again, if a compound has no task, it does not appear on the task tab. If a compound has neither a category nor a task, you can add it to a tree only by dragging it from a file browser. You can enter a completely new string to create a new category, task, or subtask. In this case, use deformation for the task and effects for the subtask. Click the X to exit the compound. If you open the compound's property editor now, you can see controls for the ports that you exposed. To export your compound, right-click on it and choose Export Compound. By default, compounds are exported to your Softimage user directory. The data compound subfolder of the user, workgroup, and factory locations are all scanned recursively for compounds to appear in the preset manager. Once exported, the compound appears in the specified task and subtask, ready to be used with other objects and scenes. Now try the compound in a different scene. Create an ice tree on the object that you want to deform, drag in the compound and a reference to the controller object, and hook up the connections. If you ever modify and re-export your compound, make sure to change the version numbers first. Update the minor version for simple bug fixes, and update the major version for bigger changes in functionality. This ensures that new instances of the compound always use the most up-to-date version, while compounds that contain the modified compound can get the version they are compatible with.